This assignment to all of you shows that the everybody is expecting exponential growth in testing. So almost 45% of you saying that we expect exponential growth in testing. So that's very good. And constant about 45. So I think still a significant portion of you saying that testing is going to grow at a massive pace. So that's very good for all of us. The other part we asked is about in terms of share of testing in the total project timeline. 30% or 10%. I think this falls into the ratio of typically about 1/3 of the budget is spent in terms of testing, about 25 to 30%. So if you look at 49%, if you're saying 30% of the total project budget is being spent on testing. So if somebody is not giving you the budget, you can go and give them this, show them this data and say that we need 30% of the budget, and not at the last minute. Typically, many a times what happens is testing budgets are given at the last minute and then you don't have time to ramp up. So this data shows that, at least from all of you, that 30% of the budget in any software project needs to be spent on testing. So that's one data. Then this is one more data that was kind of changed from 2013 to 2014. The percentage of test automation achieved in organizations. So we talked about few trends in the throughout in the last 2 days, and we said mobility is one area and automation could be the other. And that's also shown about a significant 40% what used to be 31 has moved to 40 in terms of 25 to 50% of automation being achieved. And there is at least about another 24% of organization that are like more than 50% automation. So automation is here to stay and it will be growing. And like we mentioned in the some of the discussions, DevOps as a concept is coming up, and that means a lot more automation. So this is one area there will be significant investments in automation in some of the tools. So, okay, the next question was in terms of foremost challenge in test execution area. What is the biggest challenge that testing faces? And I think it is simple that the requirement volatility still is the highest issue, but it's moved up from being 40% to 53%. So what's happening? The agile world and DevOps, all that has created a lot more requirement volatility, and that ratio is shown in terms of almost like a jump of around 13%, 40 to 53%. So that's from a requirement volatility. Tester to developer ratio, this is almost falling into the same of 1/3. We asked this question as to how much a team needs to have. Here, tester to developer ratio, if you look at 1:3 tester is almost like 37%, and 1:2 developer is 26%. So you're finding significant investment in testing. Like we mentioned, some companies are even have 1:1 tester to developer ratio. Microsoft was, in fact, the first company to do that. I don't know if the ratios are similar at this point of time, but the tester to developer ratio should be at least 1:3. So that's what is the data is showing. This is an interesting one. I think in terms of open source to commercial tools, I think the trend was 62% said more open source than license. I think CA and maybe some of our colleagues have to do something about that. So more open source than license, but I think it is reduced a bit in terms to 57%, not a significant reduction. There are a lot of, and more licensed than open source is 7%, and mixed is 36. So a lot more people using open source tool than license tool in multiple areas. So there is 3 areas, typically test management, automation and performance testing. So these are the 3 areas where you use tools. Are testing metrics being used effectively? This was more from a process and TMMI, those areas. How is testing metrics used effectively? I think somewhat agree is 36, but I think a lot of people use agree to the fact, 47% that testing metrics is used effectively. But there is one question in the panel as to what metrics would be ideal in a testing scenario. I think typically cost per test case, or defect, number of defect found in testing expertise. So we are finding that companies are investing in terms of domain expertise, be it banking or be it retail, those sectors. The other domain that, not domain exactly, is technology, SAP, PeopleSoft, those areas. So either it will be from a sectoral domain expertise or technology areas that investment would happen. So you see that, but also that soft skill about 5%, I think it could have been a lot more, because sometimes recruitment time, many people do care about the soft skills that are there. Is development expertise required for a good tester? I think majority of you say that development experience is good. Last year it was 59, this year it's 52. I think I don't know the reason for this reduction, but it's not a significant reduction. So that's from what development experience is it needed for a good tester? And what this is, last year the smack in terms of social media, mobility, cloud computing and analytics was kind of coming up, and we asked this question, where would investment happen? And at that point of time, there was a spread of areas in terms of mobile and cloud. But very clearly, the mobile space is emerging as the significant investment that's happening in the testing area. So highest potential for innovation for companies, IT services, or when you reach out to, or even internally within IT divisions, is in the mobile space. So that's almost like 39% scale there. And so that's just the results of the survey that we did. Thanks for participation. And what we do is we compile this as a thought leadership. We have put a lot more interpretation in terms of each area, what can be done. And we will release it in about 3 months' time along with Unicom. Thanks for participating in this.
This event would not have been possible without the sponsors. This event would not have been possible without the speakers as well. They have contributed a lot. Many of them have prepared, have been preparing since last 3 months. And, they have put in a lot of their efforts to come up with something that can excite you, that can motivate you, that can help you learn. We would like to, recognize them. So we'll be starting with the speakers who spoke from day one. Most of them received it because they had to leave. They came from other cities, so we gave them. But those who are here, we would like to honor them on stage. So we'll start first. So to honor the speakers, can I have Mr. Raman from KPMG to come on stage, please? So Mr. Raman is partner in KPMG, and he leads the excellence and business excellence division, including software testing. So we'd like to invite
from the top. First is my name, actually. Okay, so let's go to the next one.
Let's
so,
at least have a round of applause.
Prashant Shantakumaran, director KPMG, amongst the top six speakers, along with Mr. Rajesh Kannan, amongst the so their talk was rated amongst the top six by all of you. It's based on the feedback that we saw outside. Head of Competency Testing Services, Tech Mahindra. Anyone from Tech Mahindra can please come forward and take on his behalf. Yes, sir. Mr. Santosh Tupper. software tester and blogger from the company Test in Sage. He's not here, but he's the top speakers of this year's conference. Mr. Kishore Kamath, Vice President, Testing Queen Ops, he left yesterday because he came from Mumbai. Mr. Rahul Verma, Director and Chief Technology Officer, Test Mind Software. He has been consistently being awarded the best speaker in our testing conferences. He gave a session which was very inspiring.
Hello, Kumar Pandey and Rakshit Muthappa from Snyder Electric.